The restricted crossing U-turn intersection, also known as a J-turn or super street, improves performance by prohibiting left-turn movements onto the major roadway from the side street. Instead, left-turning vehicles must turn right at the main roadway and execute a U-turn at a dedicated U-turn bay several hundred feet away from the main intersection. Both signalized and unsignalized RCUTs can be built. The Highway Capacity Manual procedure for unsignalized restricted crossing U-turns is highly similar to the Urban Streets procedure, but with a few key adjustments. The Urban Streets procedure calculates the delay experienced by each vehicle at each intersection approach. For unsignalized U-turn crossovers, approach delays are computed using the Hcm procedures for unsignalized intersections. After the approach delays have been computed, it is then necessary to calculate the extra distance travel time, also known as EDTT. The calculation for extra distance travel time takes into account distances from the main intersection to the U-turn crossover, free flow speed along the arterial, and the effects of acceleration and deceleration. At RCUT intersections, extra distance travel time is applicable to all drivers who arrive on the minor street but desire to make a left-turn movement or through movement. These left-turn and through movement vehicles must travel around the U-turn crossover to complete their movement. Extra distance travel time is the time required to drive this extra distance. Experience travel time is equal to the summation of approach delays and extra distance travel times. Facility-wide level of service is based on the average amount of experience travel time per vehicle. Thanks to the elimination of left-turn phases, facility-wide level of service is often better for an RCUT intersection when compared to a conventional intersection. Hcm example problems are available for RCUT intersections with either signalized or unsignalized U-turn crossovers.